Dear students, good morning. I am Dr. Annie Frieda, postgraduate teacher from SLB Government High Secondary School, Nagarkoil. In this video, we are going to see an important 5 marks question, self-inductance of a long solenoid from electromagnetic induction and alternating current lesson, 4th lesson of plaster physics. Consider a long solenoid of length L. Solenoid of length L and cross-sectional area A. Its cross-sectional area, the turn's cross-sectional area is A. Let small n be the turn density, that is number of turns divided by the length, that is the turn density, and I is the current flowing through the circuit. What will be the magnetic field produced when the current flows through the solenoid? That is B is equal to mu 0 Ni. And the magnetic flux through each turn of the solenoid. The magnetic flux is being produced. And what is the magnetic flux through each turn of the solenoid is phi B. That is equal to integral A vector B dot dA, and integral of dA vector is vector A, and vector B dot dA, it's a dot product, and for dot product we have cos theta, right? B dot A will be BA cos theta, so phi B will be BA cos theta. Since theta is equal to 0, why do we take theta to be 0? See, the area is here, area is in this direction. So, unit vector of A will be along x-axis. Unit vector is always perpendicular to the area. Unit vector of A is always perpendicular to the area, and so it will be along x-axis. But B produced, B induced is also along the x-axis, and so the angle between B and vector A, vector B and vector A is 0. And so what is cos 0 is 1, right? So phi B will be equal to BA. But we know that B is equal to mu 0 Ni, so flux phi B will be equal to mu 0 Ni into A, right? Then the total magnetic flux linked with the solenoid of n turns. There are n turns, right? So what will be the total magnetic flux? It will be n times phi B. That is equal to n times mu 0 Ni into A. But capital N is equal to NL. So, NL into mu 0 Ni into A, or mu 0 into N square ALI. We know that N phi is equal to LI. N phi B is equal to LI. We know that. And so, see here, N phi is equal to mu 0 N square AL into I. So, L could be written as mu 0 N square AL. If the solenoid is filled with dielectric, see if the solenoid is filled with dielectric, or if the solenoid is wound on a dielectric of relative permeability mu r, then we can write L as mu 0 mu r n square AL, or mu 0 mu r could be written as mu, and so L will be equal to mu n square AL. So this is the value of self-inductance of a long solenoid. This 4.32 self-inductance of a long solenoid is an important 5 marks question. I hope you have very well understood the concept. If there is any doubt, please ask me in the comment box. Thanks for watching. Thank you.